in each of the questions given below, a group of digits are given followed by letters. I think four combinations of letters, numbered 1, 2, 3 and 4. You have to find out which of the four combinations correctly represents the group of digits below. If none of the four combinations represent the group of digits correctly, give 5. That is none as the answer there. Now, there are some conditions to be followed while answering such questions. Look at the first one there. It says, if the last digit as well as the fourth digits are even, both are to be coded by the code of the first digit. Right? Second condition says, if the first as well as the second digits are odd, then both codes are to be interchanged. Right? We have solved such questions earlier, in the video there. So, nothing to be explained here. Let's start working on it. So, the first one here is 357416. 357416. 357416. See what happens. There are two conditions. The first condition is about fourth digit and the last digit. Are they even? Here, if you look at it, first, second, third, fourth digit is even, which is 4 itself, right? Fourth digit is even. Last digit is also even. That condition satisfies. So, you have to follow that condition. And then, if the first as well as the second digits are odd, first and second digits are odd. Yes, 3 and 5. First digit and second digit are odd. Let's apply both the conditions. See what happens. So, if the first and the, if the fourth and the last digits are even, then both are to be coded by the code of first digit. Both are to be coded. Which both, this 4 and 6 here, are to be coded by the code of first digit. What is the first digit? 3. You're getting my point? When the fourth digit and the last digit are even, both are to be coded by the code of the first letter. The first digit. The first digit is 3. What's the code for 3? I think 3's code will be P. Right? So here we should mark P and T for both this. Then the second condition also falls. The second condition says, if the first as well as the second digits are odd, if the first as well as the second digits are odd, both codes are to be interchanged. Both codes means 3 and 5. These two codes are to be interchanged. The codes for 3 and 5. What is the code for 3? I think we have just got P, right? What is the code for 5? 5 is going to be D. Right? So P and D. But we have to interchange. So this will become D and P. So DP dash P dash P. Now we need to look at codes for 7 and 1. What's the code for 7? The code for 7. In fact, you can verify the answer options there. If there any option which gets cancelled because of this coding so far. Right? Answer should start with DP. The correct answer should start with DP. So first option, second option, third option are ruled out. Fourth option is possible. See, DP, that has got DPMP. So maybe fourth option is correct. Let's check. And then the code for 7. What's the code for 7? The code for 7 is L. Right? The code for 7 is L. So what should come here? L. And the code for 1. What's the code for 1? It is M. So what's your answer? DPLPMP. DPLPMP. But that's not there. Option 5, right? Option 5. None of this is the answer. Look at second one. 734192. 734192. And I'm sure you can answer this easily, right? 734192. What you have to do? First condition says, if the fourth and the last digit are even. No. 1 is not even. So this is ruled out. First condition is ruled out. Second condition says, if the first and the second digits are odd. Yes. 7 and 3 both are odd. Then their codes have to be interchanged. What is the code for 3? P. So that P should come here because the codes have to be interchanged. What is the code for 7? The code for 7 is L. So that L would come here. And then 4192. The code for 4 is F. The code for 1 is M. The code for 9 is B. And that for 2 is V. So I think the answer should be PLFMBV. PLFMBV. None of the options, right? Fifth option, none of this has to be the correct answer. And similarly, the sixth one, right? 123682. What do we do? 123682. So the fourth and the last digits are even. Yes. And the second condition is not satisfied, right? Second condition says both first and second digits are odd. But here the second digit is even. So only the first condition has to be applied. And the first condition says, when the fourth and the last digits are even, both are coded as the code for first digit. What is the first digit? 1. What is the code for 1? The code for 1 is M. So 6 is coded as M. 2 is also coded as M. And of course, 1 will also be M. Now 2, 3 and 8. What is the code for 2? It is V. The code for 3 is P and 8 is R. So the answer for this one should be MVPMRM. MVPMRM option 2.
In a certain code language, The phrase given give solution for problem is coded as hash e4 dollar r3 you know star m7 at the rate n8. Similarly, pure first sale grade, you know, at the rate e4 dollar t5 hash t5 star e4. Then pet sensed ghostly form, there's some codes given there. Spa guards picked flake, some codes given there, right? And then two questions have been asked here. Now usually in such type of questions where we have been given some phrases with their codes in some language, you know that we have to work on the common words. There are words which are common in multiple phrases or multiple sentences. We have to find out the codes accordingly based on what is common on the right hand side and go ahead with the solutions. But surprisingly, if you look at the given phrases here, there is nothing that is getting repeated in these phrases, right? Look at the word give. It is only in the first one. Second, third, fourth have not got the word give. Similarly, solution is unique. For, problem, pure, first, sale, great, pet, sensed, ghostly, form, spa, guards, picked, flake. All these 16 words here are unique. And here comes the problem. If they are all unique, how do we identify the code? Like for example, what could be the code for give? There are four possibilities. It could be hash e4, it could be dollar r3, it could be star m7 or at the rate n8. Similarly, what will be the code for spa? It could be hash s6, it could be star d6, it could be dollar e5 or at the rate a3. You getting it? You cannot find out the code simply by mapping or, you know, the way we have solved those type of questions in the past. This is not similar to what we have seen in the past, right? So in that case, I'm sure most of us would say that answers cannot be determined. Like for example, the question here says, what is the code for search from page? The code for search from page. Now, if you look at the given words here, search has not been used at all. The word from has also not been used at all. Page also is not used in any of the statements. So maybe one thought that strikes is that, you know, the answer should not have any of these codes. Like for example, if you look at star e4 at the rate h6 dollar m4, you see that dollar m4 is already available here, which means dollar m4 is the code for either pet or sensed or ghostly or form, which are not there in this word in this sentence. So we can probably say option one is wrong. Similarly, you may find the other options to be wrong, and then you can say answer cannot be determined. And moreover, he's asking us to find out what is the code for search from page. He's not asking us for a possible code. You getting it? So maybe answer, or you know, you can say that answer cannot be determined. Similarly, if you look at the next question here, it says, what is the code for solution? What is the code for solution? The solution again is a new word. The word solution, okay, not a new word. The word solution has been used in the first phrase here, right? So we can say the answer can either be hash e4, dollar r3, star m7, at the rate n8. So hash e4 is given, dollar r3 is given, star m7 is given, at the rate n8 is given. So maybe answer for this question also is cannot be determined. So I'm sure if not all, some of you have at least marked the answer as cannot be determined. I will be very honest, even I thought the answers should be cannot be determined for these two questions. But then when I looked at the remaining questions, I realized that no, this is not what we are assuming it to be, right? The logic here is not based on the repetition of words, but it is something else, right? So we cannot follow the same process that we have used in such type of questions in the past. So how is the code being decided? Let me explain that to you, right? Focus on this, all of you. The one point that all of you need to observe here is that the first letter of the words are same in all the four sentences here. See, G, S, F, P. Here also you find G, S, F, P. Here also we have G, S, F, P. Here again we have, you know, G, S, F, P. So clearly the words starts with either G, right, or S, or F, or P. You're able to follow G, S, F, or P. Now how do you decide? Again, if you look at the coded side here, the symbols that we have used are only four different types: hash, dollar, star, at the rate. You see, hash, dollar, star, at the rate, right? Again here, hash, dollar, star, at the rate, hash, dollar, star, at the rate. Okay, so definitely this hash, dollar, star, at the rate have to be mapped to GSFP. We'll have to identify whether G starts with, I mean, G is coded as hash or S is coded as hash or what is coded as hash and dollar and star and iterate. So that is one point which we can observe here. Look at other points, right? I'll tell you what actually is happening here, right? I mean, you know, in coding and decoding, there is no solution. There's only an answer. I can tell you what is the logic here. Now, the logic here is as follows. G is always coded as hash, right? S is always coded as at the rate. I'll tell you how we get to know this, right? Just focus on this first. F is always coded as dollar and P is coded as star. So if you go by that, G is coded as hash. So it's hash here. Now look at it. If you observe the codes, there is one symbol always. The second element is a letter and the third element is a number. All the codes, look at all the codes. There is one symbol followed by a letter, followed by a number. So I have already told you that G is coded as hash. Now what is this letter E? How are we getting this letter E? This letter E is nothing but the last letter of the word which starts with G. See this E. Give is the word, it starts, it ends with E, right? That comes in the next position. And what is this number 4? How do we arrive at the number 4? The number 4 is a count of letters in the word give. 1, 2, 3, 4 letters. So it comes 4 here. You're able to follow. So if you look at give, how do we code the word? G is coded as hash, so take hash. The next position should be a letter. Which letter? The last letter, E. The next position should be a number. What is that number? The number of letters here. So it is 4. Similarly, randomly let me pick up the word sensed. Sensed. See what happens. Sensed. The word starts with S. We know that the code for S is at the rate. The second position here should be a letter. That letter should be the last letter, which is D. And the third position should be, the third element should be a number. And that number is a count of letters, which is 6. So we can conclude that sensed is coded as at the rate D6. Sense is coded as at the rate D6. See, it's available here. Give is coded as hash E4. So the point is, again, one more point to be noted is, sensed is second word here, but the code is in the third position. So that shuffling is allowed. You're able to follow. So the logic is very simple. Each word is coded with three elements. The first element is a symbol. Second element is a letter. Third element is a number. The symbol coding, I've already told you, this is what is being done there. Letter here is the last letter of the word, which starts with G or S or F or a P. And the number here is the count of letters in the given word. Right? Now, a big question that would, you know, cross your mind now is, how do I know that these are the codes for G, S, F, P? No, I don't know. It is how it was used. As simple as that. I mean, maybe if you see next time onwards when such type of questions are asked, you don't have to worry about how to get this codes. Just focus on the last letter and the count of letters, you'll get to know. Like, for example, if I look at, you know, the word first, it is ending with T. Find out the code which has got T in middle. Okay, there are 2. And then there are 5. So this may not be helpful. Look at this word, ghostly. The word ghostly ends with Y. So find out which code has got the second letter as Y. This one. So I can now say that G is coded as hash. And why 7 here? 7 is the number of letters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. So that's how we can identify the codes if you want. Like for example, if you look at pigged, ends with D. So definitely the code's second element should be D. Now where is the second element D here? 6 is clearly the number of letters. So I can say star belongs to P, or P is coded as star. P is coded as star. So that's how we can decide if you want to. Alright? So very simple logic, but then difficult to arrive at when you are solving this in the exam. And based on that, now I'm sure you can answer all the questions very easily. So you don't even have to look at this data now. You're able to follow. You don't have to look at the data to answer the questions. Questions can be answered even without the common data because the logic is very simple. Three-step process. So what is the code for search from page? Now search. S is coded as at the rate. Last letter is H. And number of letters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At the rate H6. So clearly the answer should have at the rate H6. Look at the options. At the rate H6 is available. Second option, it's not available. At the rate H5, not available. Not correct. This fourth option is wrong. Third option is also wrong. Cannot be determined, cannot be the answer, because answer can be determined. So I can clearly say that second, third, fourth and fifth options are wrong. Hence, first option is correct. If you want, quickly verify for the remaining words as well. From, F is coded as dollar, M last letter and 4. Dollar M4. Page, P is coded as star, last letter is E and 4, star E4, star E4. You getting it?
So first option is the answer. Look at the second one. What is the code for solution?
What is the code for solution? What is the code for solution? You need not look at the data there. Solution S. S is coded as at the rate. Last letter is N. So it starts with at the rate. Second letter is N. So first option, second option, third option are eliminated. Either, I mean, fourth option is the answer because cannot be determined is ruled out. Answer is always, doable. I mean, logic, you can find out the answer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So at the rate N, 8.
Option 4 is the answer. Right? So that's how you solve this question. Let us quickly look at the remaining ones. I think there are more questions. So what I would do is, the only thing that you'll have to remember is G is hash. Let me just clear this up. Yeah. Now answer the questions. There are three more questions here, right? Answer these questions now. Which of the following code can be coded for friends? Friends, F. F should be coded as dollar. Last letter is S. And the count of letters is 8, right? So dollar S8. Dollar S8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, oh, 7, 7 letters. So dollar S7. Dollar S8 is not there in the option. So I realize that something is wrong in my calculation. You're able to follow. Friends, so F is coded as dollar. Last letter is S. And the count is 7. So dollar S7. Dollar S7, option 3. Look at the next one. What is the code for gross? G. G should be coded as hash. Last letter is S. And the count of letters is 5. Hash S5. Hash S5 is option 1. Alright? And the last one now. Last one from this question type. Here's the question. Right? What is the code for payment? Payment. What is the code for payment? P. P should be code as star. Last letter is T. Count of letters 7. So star T7. Option 3 would be the answer.